this video, I would like to remind you one thing. How is that Ram Bahadur Bumjon could have meditated, he could have managed to sit in his meditation performance at least 10 months in 2005 and in the following months, during the time when there was a Maoist insurgence and there had been fears that he could be in danger from the Maoists. So these fears had been expressed only by foreigners, because the Nepalese knew the situation in the area, and the Nepalese knew that Ram Bahadur Bumjon had been, and now this will be a surprise for you, had been supported by the Maoists. When you watch the evolvement of Ram Bumjon's criminal cases from 2006 until today, then you realize that the Maoist politicians had been always supporting Ram Bahadur Bumjon, currently the leader of the Maoist Communist Party, Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachanda, who had been many times Nepal's prime minister, if I remember at least 4 times, and he's believed to become the next prime minister because of the ill K.P. Sharma Oli, who is actually also a Maoist. And the police investigation into the cases which had emerged in 2018 and 2019, including the rape of Gangamaya Tamang, the murder of Sanchalal Vaiva, and the disappearance of Chunmo, Dolmo, Molam Lama, Rita Bhatt, and some other people, and the rape of some other nuns and girls. All these cases had been stopped, the investigation had been stopped due to the order of Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachanda, the leader of the current Maoist party, at the memorandum of Bumjon's political supporters, including mainly Mani Lama, a former health minister, Bhuminand Devkota, a Maoist party member, and other people who are connected to politics, like Chatra Gissing, who is also Bumjon's follower, of course, and he was working or is working in the municipality of Sindhuli district, where Bumjon has his biggest ashram, interesting, and the biggest land he had acquired. So the Maoist party is always standing behind Bumjon, and you should know why. And I had the fortune or misfortune, I don't know how to say, to learn a lot of things about Ram Bahadur Bumjon and his family while I was staying either in his compound or in the houses of his followers. So I spent 5 months in Pilua village, which is just 6 kilometers from Halkoria jungle, and in the family of Jas Bahadur Vaiba. And actually Bumjon's, one of his bigger sisters, because he's from 9 siblings, Rajkumari, was our neighbor. she had married into that village Pilua as well. And for a short time also Bumjon's small sister Ranjita had been studying in the Bara Academy there. But not going into unnecessary details, I would like to tell you that this Rajkumari, who used to be also for some time Bumjon's nun until she didn't marry, this Rajkumari used to be, and now the shock is coming, a Maoist fighter. Because it is well known that during the Maoist times, girls and women had been also fighting on the side of the Maoists. And it's not really something that we should condemn people for, especially local villagers, because they didn't have choice. If they wanted to survive, they needed the support of the Maoists. Otherwise, the Maoists would either kill them or rape their daughters, or and they would just steal all their properties. So I believe that for these reasons, the Bomjon family had been supporting the Maoists. So here we come to the interesting coincidence that Rambadur Bomjon, even if he sat in the jungle and meditated, he was not disturbed by anyone. And if we see the videos, the earliest videos, he is supported by the APF police. And it's well known that not only the army but also the APF police had been in Nepal, had been formed, not formed originally, but a lot of previous Maoist fighters, this was the actually the initiative of Pushpa Kamal Dahal, a lot of Maoist fighters had been reshifted into the Nepali army and the Nepali APF armed police forces police, these blue uniformed policemen. And they are protecting Bomjon actually. So during the Maoist insurgents, we see that Maoists are protecting Bomjon, and the APF police, many of whom had been former Maoist fighters, had been all the time around Bomjon, coming to bow to him, lining up for the blessings. We have a lot of videos, photos about it. I have seen it with my own eyes. So here we come to the conclusion that if the Maoist army and the APF police force, which had an army camp just at Halkoria jungle, that army camp was and maybe is called Bhadrakali army camp, because I haven't gone there a few years to this area. So if there are former Maoist fighters, obviously they will continue to protect and support Rambadur Bomjon against his victims. So the victims had never ever received any protection from the police in Bara. The police always helped Rambadur Bomjon to harm the victims and cover up the criminal cases. And it's not just my case, of course. I'm not speaking out about my case. There are 72 victims by now. And I will detail all these cases. I will list them. And you will see that the police, although the cases had been reported to the police never ever prosecuted Bomjon or his followers for the crimes they did to so many people. So how it is that Rambadur Bomjon had been protected by the Maoists, and until today, as we see, the main leader of the Maoist party, Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachanda, is protecting Bomjon against his victims, be it rape victims, be it the families of his murder victims. They don't care, because they are comrades. The comrades' philosophy is that they don't care about the other dead people. They are comrades, they are in the same, he had been supported by the same party. So that's why there is no chance in Nepal until the Maoists and communists are leading for the Bomjon's victims. But because they are very clever, they also spread their nets to the Congress parties. So they managed to fool Sushil Koirala, who was a Congress party prime minister in 2014. But he was actually a very religious prime minister. So Sushil Koirala was gullible. He was He was supporting the Brahma Kumari movement. He was supporting many mandirs. He was interested in dharma. Sushil Koirala was not even married. He was even respected for his approach to dharma. And Bomjon had misused, hijacked this vulnerability of Sushil Koirala. And his followers, Mani Lama, Chatragi Singh, and the others, had sneaked inside this Congress party as well. There are other connections as well, because Mani Lama had been a health minister during the time of the King Gyanendra, a very short time of kingdom, when it was the Congress party which was ruling together with the king. And this Mani Lama had been a member, obviously, of this Congress party. But he had been, I read it only on Setopati, it's not really available information, he had been kicked out from the Congress party. Of course, he's not boasting about that. He's boasting about him being a one-time health minister, so that he has a bigger authority. And so let's go back to the times of 2005 and before that, when this Rajkumari, Bomjon's big sister, was a Maoist fighter lady. She actually had been jailed by the government, because there were, of course, the Maoist war means that the government was fighting with the Maoists. And during the time when she was jailed, now it's a very interesting story, and I heard it from a person who is very near to all these families and knows all the details. During that time, Bomjon, Ram Bahadur Bomjon, the miracle maker, savior of the world, he was unhappy and he wanted his sister to get out from the jail. He had no power to do it by his miraculous power, so he had to ask the then smuggling mafia leader, Jas Bahadur Vaiba of Pilwa, to release his big sister Rajkumari from the jail. And because everyone knew that Jas Bahadur Vaiba had guns, he was the man of power, local power, and he also had very good contacts with politicians, because Nepali politicians quite a lot of times are intervened with the criminals and mafias and smugglers. And so those times it was even more like that, or it was just well known. And he had contact to the politicians, obviously, from the times, because he needed a backup for his activities, for his mafia activities. And that backup was the politician contacts. And Jas Bahadur Vaiba had a Tamil base, a tourist hub of Kathmandu, as well as the crime hub of Kathmandu is Tamil. And so he also lived in Tamil time to time and lived in Pilua time to time. And so it was very easy. Jas Bahadur Vaiba contacted his political contacts. And now we have to realize that those contacts had to be the Congress party, because those times the Maoist party was not was in opposition, was underground. This was a fighter. So those contacts had to be from the Congress party, which is nowadays the second most powerful party in Nepal, and the leader of this Congress party is Sher Bahadur Deuba, who is also a supporter of Ram Bahadur Bomjon. And Sher Bahadur Deuba in 2018 had invited Ram Bahadur Bomjon to his prime minister residence, because in the beginning of 2018 Sher Bahadur Deuba was the prime minister of Nepal. So you have to be to study a lot the Nepali realities. A prime minister's term is rarely in Nepal 4 years. It's always changing and re-election. And anyway, it was Sherbahadur Deuba who invited Bomjon in 2018 to the Baluwatar, the prime minister residence, and granted Rambadur Bomjon. Re-granted him the Halkoria jungle compound, which had been cleared out and joined by the Parsa National Park and the London Zoo by the foreigners charity. And then when they cleared it up, then they gifted it to Rambadur Bomjon, who was the main reason that Halkoria jungle became destroyed. Ecological disaster was caused by there by Rambadur Bomjon. But Sherbahadur Deuba had gifted this Halkoria jungle, the place where I had been kidnapped and tortured, and the place where people had been raped and murdered and tortured like me, that place had been gifted by the Congress Party Prime Minister in 2018 back to Rambahadur Bomjon. He had been evicted from there, from the local government in 2012, just after I had been kidnapped and held, tortured on chains in that jungle, and just after he attacked his own family members, Rambahadur Bomjon, I mean. So this is the setting, and then you have this same, Rambahadur Vaiba is asking this same party, the Congress Party, to take out from prison Rambahadur Bomjon's bigger sister, the Maoist fighter. And according to the story, as it was told to me, it was a matter of 5 minutes. Obviously, Rambahadur Bomjon, who was totally powerless, the enlightened Buddha, he was powerless to take out his own big sister from jail. He had to ask a mafia leader to take it, to do it. And obviously, Jasbahadur Vaiba was always very rich, and that time he also used his money. So Rambahadur Bomjon was extremely grateful to Jasbahadur Vaiba that he released his big sister. And their connection, this symbiosis, is lasting until today. And until today, you see Jasbahadur Vaiba as one of the most active supporters of Bomjon, and who is bribing all the police to cover up his crimes and silence the victims. And Jasbahadur Vaiba knows about all the victims, including the mysterious case of the first foreigner who had been kidnapped by Bomjon in 2007, something like that, 2006, end of 2006, the earliest years, and that was a Spanish woman, because that Spanish woman had been also accommodated in the Pilua house of Jasbahadur Vaiba, and she had been kidnapped by Bomjon and held many weeks in the jungle, and released again to the house of Jasbahadur Vaiba. So Jasbahadur Vaiba, he liked to present himself like a kind of helper of the foreigners, because he speaks good English. He is connected to Germany. He lived in Germany sometimes, because in Harmburg there is his brother. He's called also Vaiba. He's a German citizen. And the two sons of Jasbahadur Vaiba's brother, Suman Vaiba and Uman Vaiba, are also living in Germany. And I think they have citizenship, German citizenship. And they are also involved in the criminality of Rambahadur Bomjon, in the tortures and cover-ups. And they were there when Bomjon was torturing me. And they agree with that. They know about all these cases. So German citizens, yes, you can be happy in Europe. You have people who are helping Rambahadur Bomjon and his cult to torture, kidnap, rape and murder 72 victims, including me, one European citizen. So back to the Maoists, this is what actually is the story why Ram Bahadur Bomjon is so grateful to Jasbahadur Waiba, and why the Maoists are still helping Bomjon, because he looked after that one of their fighters, Rajkumari, had been released by the help of Ram Bahadur Bomjon and Jasbahadur Waiba. So for that group of people, it doesn't matter that victims like me are chained, bones broken, raped, tortured, or even murdered. For them, the holy thing is their connection, their promise to each other. It's like a contract among them. So this is the story of the Maoist connection, and you would be not surprised. Was an election, then it happened by an incident that I stayed in Ram Bahadur Bomjon's Bungjor village, where he was born, opposite Ratanpuri. And because I like his family and like his mother, I slept a few days even in his house. At that time I was still half brainwashed. I was not able to totally reject Ram Bahadur Bomjon either. I was trying to leave all doors open and try to understand what did happen to me. So I cannot claim that I was totally healed from from the fanatic worship and the devotion and this fanatic approach to him. And so I had no problem to live in his house, and they already rejected him because he already tortured them. He tortured them April 2012, and I was there in the later months of 2012, just a few days. And there were the elections, I didn't know that time what does it mean, Emale. There is one party called Emale. This is actually one of the many Maoist fractions, but it's a communist Maoist party. And I realized that Bomjon's brother, Dil, was voting Emale. And they were very enthusiastic about this, you know, in this fever, pre-election fever, going around with transparents and shooting from loudspeakers. And I was surprised how it is that a family, we foreigners would understand that a communist party cannot be religious because the communist and Maoist philosophy is against religion. But they are actually supporting the Maoist and communist parties in the elections.